Hurricane Beryl, now a Category 4 storm after briefly strengthening to a Category 5 Monday night.
Yeah, the storm now heading for Jamaica and the Cayman Islands, leaving a path of destruction in its wake. And WGN's Alyssa Donovan here now with more. Alyssa?
Yeah, Dina and Ray, Beryl became the earliest storm to develop into a Category 5 hurricane in the Atlantic last night. Winds reached 165 miles per hour. Now a slight downgrade to a Category 4 storm, which is still incredibly strong and dangerous, with sustained winds of 155 miles per hour. Beryl is carving a path towards Jamaica, where it's expected to make landfall tomorrow morning.
I didn't think that the damage would be so much.
People who live in the Southeast Caribbean assessing the damage in the wake of Hurricane Beryl. That's where the storm made landfall on Monday, killing at least six people before churning back out into the Atlantic, gaining strength from unseasonably warm waters.
The water there is hotter than it would normally be at the peak of the season. So, you know, that's pretty amazing. In terms of sea surface temperature, yeah, it's warmer than it ever gets during the peak of the season.
Beryl briefly strengthened to a Category 5 hurricane Monday night, the earliest in the season a storm of that caliber has ever been recorded. Packing winds of 165 miles per hour. Beryl losing some intensity on Tuesday, set to pass south of Haiti tonight, where the UN is working to take measures to help Haitians currently caught in the middle of a violent humanitarian crisis. Many are already displaced without proper social services or food.
About 300,000 people. Displaced people in Haiti or children, and that's about half of all internally displaced people in that country.
The World Health Organization prepared to provide assistance to the area if needed, while others in the storm's path are being told to evacuate. The National Hurricane Center forecasting the storm is still expected to be a strong major hurricane as it passes near or over the island of Jamaica on Wednesday before moving on to the Cayman Islands and into Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula. Significant storm surge, wind, and rainfall expected to cause flooding, mudslides, and widespread damage in its path.
Jamaica, the Cayman Islands, Cuba, and Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula expected to receive 4 to 8 inches of rainfall as Beryl passes, with isolated locations forecast to receive more than a foot of rainfall. Back to you guys.
Wow, some incredible intensity. Alyssa, thanks for that.